easily record in Tracktion Waveform by either punching in and out on the fly or by using the auto punch method. This Tracktion Waveform tutorial will work with both Waveform Free and Waveform 11 Pro. I'm Zane from AudioTechTV.com, and on this channel, I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. And recently, I was asked to do a Tracktion Waveform tutorial on punch recording. And there are two ways to do punch recording in Waveform. So let's quickly look at both. And if you aren't sure what punch recording is, it's basically recording parts onto a track while playing it back. So if there's a few bars on a track that you want to fix up, but you want to leave the rest of the recording in place, you can use punch recording to start playing along before you actually record. And then when it punches in, you'll be recording and you'll only record the section that you want. So you'll keep the rest of your recording intact. It's kind of hard to explain right now, but you'll see what I mean when we get into this tutorial. So first, let's look at the more traditional way of setting up your punch in and punch out points, which is also known as auto punch. So first, you want to move the markers up here to cover the section that you want to punch in and punch out of. This is the section you want to record. And I'm going to set it like this. Now we're going to arm the track for recording. Now make sure the punch button is pressed in and the loop button is not pressed in. You can't have the loop button pressed at the same time. And you want to set your playback start point several bars ahead of the actual punched in section. This way you can play along or sing along, and it's going to sound a little more natural when you hit that recording section. And once you're ready, hit record. And you can press stop whenever you're done. So that's the auto punch method. And before we get into the next way, I just want to ask, if you're enjoying this video so far, please hit that thumbs up button. It really does help the channel out, and I appreciate it so much. Now, this next way will be more for vocalists or people that are working with others, as this way is on the fly punch recording. And it can be hard for solo artists trying to play a guitar or piano and hit buttons at the same time. So if you're producing someone else or having someone else produce you, this way can really work for editing multiple sections quickly without having to set up punch in and punch out sections. So you want to make sure the punch mode is turned off. And for this, I'm just going to speak into the mic to demonstrate how it works. And you'll be able to see how this can work for instruments or vocals. So arm the track for recording, then hit the record button. All right, so this is a test of punch recording on the fly. So right now I'm recording, but if I go over here and disarm the track from recording, you can see it stopped recording, and then I press it again, it starts recording again. And you can keep doing this as it keeps playing through. And that's punching on the fly. For more Tracktion Waveform videos, click here or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.